Well, hello and welcome, and I welcome you to the kitchen. I'm Peggy, and oh yes, I'm happy today because somebody special's here. Marie Hagler is here from Clemson University. The one thing you can know about Marie, she's going to give you something that's good. It's not only good for you, but it's good. Thank you for coming, Marie. Well, you doing all right?
I'm doing good.
Glad
to
see you.
That's quite a compliment.
But today, I love this. Hidden nutrition. So you don't have to have your kids around the table and say, eat that, it's good for you. Because right away, they don't want it. So you don't mention that. You just have hidden nutrition. And they don't even know they're getting something good for them, right?
That's right. We're going to trick our kids into eating healthy. That's,
good.
That's the
good.
Spirit.
Not only kids, but everybody else.
And adults, yeah. Kids and adults alike.
Yeah.
So the two recipes I'm going to do today are both traditional-ish recipes that we are then going to add some healthy component to and try to kind of hide in some added nutrition. And that is, everybody loves macaroni and cheese, so I'm doing a butternut squash macaroni and cheese.
Ooh, so you're putting the vegetables in with the macaroni and cheese.
Yes, and the one tool when you're trying to hide things into other dishes is to have either like a blender, or I'm going to use a food processor today, because usually you're having to puree it up, so then you're hiding it in a different way. So,
and then what else? Let's see, you've got black bean.
And then black bean brownies. So
now hear about that. Brownies that are good for you.
That's
okay,
right.
Leave it to Marie.
All right, so starting with the butternut squash macaroni and cheese, of course we are going to be starting off with the butternut squash. Butternut squash are readily available this time of year.
And that means they're less expensive.
That's correct. And actually, as you were just, you nibbled on some just a minute ago, because what I did was...
I went by and I said, may I? And I tasted one. They're wonderful.
Yeah, so you can cook these just and eat them as a side. I'm putting them in a dish, but you can roast these or cook these in a variety of ways. What I did today was I peeled them, and then it was just one, actually. I used one butternut squash about this size.
One butternut squash is all you need.
All you need.
Do that.
Mm-hmm. And I peeled it, and then I cubed it up and added some onion to it. But what you could also do is cut this in half and roast it. Just have the halves, the cut side up, and roast in the oven. It'd probably take like an hour or so. When you do it this way, at 425, cubed up, it tastes like 25, 30 minutes to roast. So it's just quicker. And also you can make sure you get, for this particular dish, you want it to be all really soft.
Well, that I tell you something, that I cheated. I went by and I said, may I? And I took one. That is delicious.
Yes, it's real. And so this you could just eat now. You could just
right
go
now.
Ahead and do it. And then I used a half an onion. So this is a one diced up butternut squash.
So you've got butternut squash that you cut up in little pieces.
Little pieces.
And some onion.
Cut up into some little pieces.
All right,
as
and
well.
Then what else?
Salt and pepper. I think I did a half teaspoon of salt.
You put some salt and pepper on it.
A tablespoon and a half of olive oil. Toss it. Lay it in a baking sheet lined with aluminum foil. Bake it at 425 for 25, 30 minutes.
And then it is delicious.
You want it to get brown, like caramelized. You see some of the onions got a little over caramelized. But so once that's done, what we're going to do is now this is going to be the base of a sauce. And both of these dishes, you'll notice that the black beans are brown or black in color, so they're good to throw into brownies. Butternut squash is orange, and so it's good to throw into macaroni and cheese because you can't really tell the difference.
Oh.
So using my food processor, the first thing I'm going to do is we're going to puree this up.
They're so good the way they are. I hate to see you do anything to them.
I know. We're going to make it better. We're just going to add to the goodness here.
And these are called, I love this, hidden nutrition. And, of course, they're free for the asking from Marie Hagler and Clemson University. And we're glad to share because they have a lot of information in this little folder. So, plus the recipes.
All right, so we got half onion, a whole butternut squash, cooked and ready to go in there. And just to add some, we could puree this up just as it is.
You cut them up in pieces, and you cook the squash and the onions.
Yes, ma'am.
And you put a little olive oil or some kind of oil.
Salt, pepper, olive oil, just so it doesn't stick.
All right.
Throw it in this food processor or a blender, if you have it.
All right.
You're going to puree it up. And then I'm going to add about a half a cup of milk to this. And the rest of this milk is going to go in when we're making the sauce with cheese.
But just I hate to see you do anything to that. It's so good right now.
And you could also, this is a good start of making like a butternut squash soup.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Okay. So this has great possibilities. You You use it for one thing, but it's possible to use many things with it.
That's right.
So these recipes are wonderful today.
All right, so that's just a little bit of milk to go in there. And then, hopefully this works. We're going to close this up, and then we're just going to puree it. So
okay.
Say goodbye to what it was. It doesn't take long. I'm going to add a little bit more milk. So you get smooth. All right.
And that's all there is to it.
Done.
Okay.
With that.
Okay.
So, and as you can see, it's just like, it almost looks like mashed sweet potatoes or something of that nature. And then we're going to add this to, make sure I'm doing this right, to that pot.
Okay.
And it's, so I'm going to use.
Now there's nothing, you don't have any oil or anything in here.
I have nothing in there.
No, okay.
Nothing.
All right.
So now what we want to do is to preheat our oven to 450. So we could just do this on the stovetop and serve it as is. I'm going to pop in the oven, put some cheese on top so it kind of gets a little more to it.
Okay.
But I'll show you, you could just leave it as is. But whatever, if you're going to put in the oven, I would use a pot that you can put in the oven, so an oven-proof skillet or pot or whatever. And you got to be careful with this little blade. That's another thing. When you use a food processor, the blade comes out, so it's not like...
Be careful.
Other things. Put this back here.
Sometimes good cooks get messy.
That's right.
There we go.
So I'm going to put this butternut squash in.
This is a little different, this recipe.
It is a little bit different. And then we're going to add cheese to it. So this is where the mac and cheese situation comes into play. I'm also using shells.
And what do you call this? Butternut squash, macaroni, and cheese.
Yes, ma'am.
All in one thing.
That's right.
All right.
Got some on the handle there. So I'm going to put this over like a medium heat. I'm going to add that we use about a cup of milk. I got 2% reduced fat milk to that puree.
Okay.
So I'm going to add a little bit more to this situation, maybe all of it. And then I might turn that up just a little bit more. So what we're trying to do at this point is we're just trying to mix the cheese and melt it and make like a cheese sauce. But mostly what it's going to end up being is a butternut squash, which is going to be rich in vitamin A, vitamin C, all the good things. So this point right here is not necessarily we're just melting cheese. So there's nothing, you're not trying to cook anything. You're just trying to kind of melt the cheese and mix it together. But
you know, one of the common sense ways to say well, especially in the wintertime, is to eat some fruits and vegetables, to pay attention to what you eat.
Sure.
Because it does help you to stay well.
Yes, it does, especially this time of year.
Now, what are you going to put in there?
Just a little salt.
Okay.
So I had a little bit of salt on when I roasted it. I'm going to add a little bit more. And then, of course, there's a little bit of salt and cheese as well.
Now, what do you
put in? So this is just a cup of grated cheddar cheese.
And this you can buy already
grated
in the store.
Because I was being lazy. But so you're just adding a cup of cheese.
Oh, this looks luscious. Look at this. Oh, Marie. This is different.
I feel good about it, though. And then I have about a half of a cup of Parmesan cheese, and I'm just going to add a little bit to this, but I'm going to top I'm going to top it with this Parmesan cheese. So, and this is one of those situations where you can really add as much or as little of cheese as you want. So do whatever you would like. So we're just going to let this cheese.
You want it all to blend.
Yeah, and it's already, make sure that's on.
Is it getting warm?
Yeah. Okay. So we're going to let that sort of melt and blend together. And see, it looks cheesy, you know? It'll be a little bit more fibrous than your normal cheese sauce. But normally when you're making a cheese sauce like this, you're adding flour, having to add a lot of cheese and a lot of cheese to it as well. Whereas this, you're adding a good bit. You're still going to get a cheesy. And it'll be a slight difference in taste. It's not going to be, But one thing about roasting that with onions, and the reason why I did that is because I made it before and just roasted it. It's really, butternut squash can be really sweet, and I wanted to make sure it was savory. And so when I added onion, it kind of cuts through that sweetness
a little
bit. Gives
it a little pizzazz.
Yeah. Because you don't, I mean, I love that the butternut squash is sweet, but in this particular dish, it can come off as kind of weirdly sweet, not necessarily in a good way.
Okay.
So once this cheese is melted a little bit and we feel good about it, we're going to add the pasta to it. Make sure I got everything in there. All right. And for this, you can add normal elbow macaroni, like you would in normal macaroni and cheese. Mm-hmm. Which is what I did when I tested it, but then today I decided that I thought shells would be good because I feel like because this sauce is kind of thick, that as you can see, like little shells have the.
So you can use whatever kind of pasta you happen to have, even.
Yeah, you could do ziti, penne, not spaghetti or.
But I like that. That's nice.
But yeah, and you could do whole wheat pasta if you're feeling real.
So this you have 16 ounces of uncooked pasta shell.
Yes, but I did already cook that.
Yeah, so you've already cooked it.
Yeah.
But
to start off with...
Is that 16 ounces?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So it makes a lot.
Yes.
Okay.
It does. And I might not. I'm going to see how this much this sauce carries. I might not add all the pasta to it. But I went ahead and cooked this. Just follow the directions on the box. Boil water. Add it to it. I didn't put any salt in there.
No.
I didn't do any...
Okay. Because you had salt in here, so you don't need any more, really.
And then all I'm going to do is add this. Let's see kind of how... Much.
Wow, I tell you, this is fun. This is kind of different. I like this.
It is a little different.
Yeah, you get tired of the same old thing. Most people do.
Mm-hmm. So this is a good little different take on a classic dish, and it's a bit more nutritious. So, give this long thing a little bit more of that pasta.
Put it all in there if you
Let's
want
do it.
To. Now this would feed quite a few people. This is a generous recipe, right?
Yes, this is like 6 to 8 for, I mean, probably 6 if you're dealing with just this. If you're doing it as a side, you can feed way more people than
and
that.
What would we have to go to a break in a minute, but what would you serve with this?
I would do some kind of salad or like, you know, roasted asparagus. Chicken of some kind. If this would be good if you're grilling chicken.
Well, this would go with hamburgers or fish or anything, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just macaroni and cheese.
Okay. I want to tell people about this because this is really good. This is called Hidden Nutrition. And this is a great little folder. Thank you, Marie. And so if you would like this, you know, they're yours free if you can send us a self-addressed stamped envelope and send it to The Peggy Denny Show, Post Office Box 1616, Greenville, South Carolina, 29602. And put on their recipe 1002. Now, what were you doing while I was talking? What did you do?
I just topped that with cheese, and now I'm going to pop it into a 450-degree oven.
We'll be right back, so don't go away.